All controls in ASP.NET can register events. To find which events a control has available, add and select a control in Design View and switch over to Events in the Properties window. At the bottom of the list, we have 5 events that can be triggered for different parts of the control's lifecycle. Above these, we have the Data Binding event, which occurs when the server control binds to a data source, such as a database. These 6 events exist for all controls. For the most part, however, the event we're interested in is the top one. For the bottom control, we find the click event. The text box has the text changed event. The checkbox has the check changed event, and so on. Some controls, such as the label, have no action events at all. To demonstrate events, let's go ahead and keep the button and text box controls and set their IDs. Now, we're going to add a click event to the button, so go back to the event list and select click. If we want to, we can type a name for the event handler here, but we can just as well leave it blank to let Visual Studio generate a name. To create the event, we can hit the return key here, or we can simply double click on the button, since this is the default event for this control. Either way, when we do, Visual Studio will take us to the code page, where it has created an empty event handler for us to use. We can see that the method name consists of the control ID and the event type, which is a good naming convention to follow. If we look at the ASPX file in source view, we can also see that the onClick property has been added to our button control, which links it to the event handler. Let's go back to the code page and add some code to our new event. We'll make it so that when the button is clicked, its label is changed to the value of the text box. If we try the application now, we can see that clicking the button indeed changes its label, just as expected.